actual living presence of Jesus, and that spending time before the Blessed Sacrament in prayer and devotion is the same as spending time with the living God. Adoration of the Most Blessed Sacrament is an affirmation of our faith. During this adoration, spoken prayers, hymns, and scripture readings, there will also be two times of approximately 20 minutes of silence. There are many ways you can enjoy that time of silence. You can read scripture, pray the rosary, meditate, thank God for your many blessings, and ask Him for help with whatever you're struggling with. You can also pray for the many needs of our world, or simply spend time with Him in silence, enjoying His presence. For the next hour, we will give witness to our belief that God is truly dwelling with His people. Today, we join in solidarity as we bring our prayers and petitions to God, as we dedicate this hour to those with the coronavirus, the home caregivers and all medical personnel who are caring for the sick, the people who died from coronavirus, and their families who are often not able to be present to comfort their loved ones, the development of therapeutics to treat those who have contracted COVID-19, and a vaccine to prevent others from getting it, and for all of us as we deal with quarantine, isolation, and anxiety during this stressful time. Deacon Bill will now remove the sacred host from the tabernacle, place it in the monstrance on the altar, as our hour of prayer and adoration begins.
Holy One of God.
We thank you for life itself, material and spiritual. We ask your forgiveness and healing for all of our shortcomings and sins, all the times that unthinkingly we have failed you and fallen short of the grace that you gave us. And finally, we place before you confidently everyone that we care about, every concern that we have, every need of our lives. We promise to trust you no matter what happens to us. You will bring good out of even the worst situations. We do not ask you to change what is to be. Rather, in whatever there is to be, let us find your will, your holiness, and your opportunity for us to grow. We will try to say, I know that you are with me. Finally, we direct our lives, our desires, our hopes to you, not only for ourselves, but for all whom we care about and for the whole world. May your kingdom come. May your Holy Spirit be with us. Send your Holy Spirit constantly to us as you promised you would at the Last Supper. As I look at this mysterious sign, the Saintly Blessed Sacrament in the white host, our eyes tell us nothing of who is there, but our faith affirms in our hearts that you, our Lord and God, are here with us. We thank you for this precious gift of faith. Amen.
Thank you. our signs, but because you ate the loaves and were filled. Do not work for food that perishes, but for the food that endures for eternal life, which the Son of Man will give you. For on him the Father God has set his seal. So they said to him, "What can we do to accomplish the works of God?" Jesus answered and said to them, "This is the work of God, that you believe in the one he sent." So they said to him, "What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat." So Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven, but my Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." So they said to him, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst. But I told you, although you have seen me, you do not believe. Everything that the Father gives me will come to me, and I will not reject anyone who comes to me, because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it up on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day." The Jews murmured about him because they said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." And they said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and his mother? How can he say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Stop murmuring among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise them up on the last day. It was written in the prophets, 'They shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate the manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true blood, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever." These things he said while teaching in the synagogue in Capernaum. Then many of his disciples who were listening said, "This saying is hard. Who can accept it?" Since Jesus knew that the disciples were murmuring about this, he said to them, "Does this shock you? What if you were to see the Son of Man ascending to where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life, while the flesh is of no avail. The words I have spoken to you are spirit and life. But there are some of you who do not believe." Jesus knew from the beginning the ones who would not believe and the one who betrayed him. And he said, "For this reason I have told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by my Father." As a result of this, many of his disciples returned to their
St. John's Gospel, you tell us that you are the bread of life, and whoever comes to you will never hunger, and whoever believes in you will never thirst. Today, Lord, we truly hunger and thirst for you. Risen Lord, this pandemic has denied us of the very Eucharist you instituted for our spiritual nourishment. Now you have a glimpse, now we have a glimpse of what so many oppressed Christians may have experienced. We sense how difficult it must have been for them to keep the Eucharist at the center of their lives. We wait in joyful hope for the time when we can be reunited with you again through Holy Communion, where we receive you fully, body, blood, soul, and divinity. At this moment, we are content just to behold you in the most blessed sacrament, and we find comfort and peace in you, even in the midst of our fears and anxieties during these uncertain times. From Psalm 42 we hear, like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul is yearning for you, my God. Christ Jesus, source of eternal life, we long to be in your loving presence, and we look forward to the day that we may once again join with the worshiping crowds amid loud cries of thanksgiving. Until that glorious day, we pray that you continue to lift our souls and encourage us to hope in you, as we praise you still, our Savior and our God. Amen.
Amen. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete. Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy. Blessed be your holy Immaculate Conception. Blessed be your glorious Assumption. Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother. Blessed be Saint Joseph, your most chaste spouse. Blessed be God and his angels,